My name's Caitlin Kalinowski. I never fully understood what engineering was until I became an engineer. What it is solving new problems by building something. That's it. I used to work on laptops, and now I work in VR. In VR, we have an artificial world. I'm very excited about the future of VR. Creativity will be at the forefront of who is successful. As a kid, I was just curious. I just wanted to make things. I think I made a nose warmer, which probably is a little bit hilarious. Like, that sort of thing is just more just exploration of how things work. When I was 5 years old, my parents got me a remote control car, and I was so excited. What I really wanted to do was understand how it worked. And so I took it apart. My parents were so confused. When I was really young, you would just get like a little set of Lego bricks and just play and create. One of the things that was really important about Lego sets is the instructions show you how to think in three dimensions. And so you have to look at a two-dimensional picture and create a three-dimensional object. That is a massively important skill in mechanical engineering, and it's something that we do every day. I wish somebody had just explained what engineering was. It wasn't until I showed some aptitude for science and math that I started to hear that word much, much older. And I finally, in college, got to start taking engineering classes and understand what it was. But it wasn't until I actually started working that I started to solve problems that no one had ever solved before, which for me is the essence of the excitement of what engineering is. I walked into a cafe and every single laptop that the 7 or 8 people were using, I'd been on the design team for. And it was just one of the coolest feelings. Every emotion that you feel in the normal world is heightened in VR. And when you're in VR and you turn left or turn right, what you see changes. So it feels like you're really there. I hope someday that I'll get a chance to go to Machu Picchu. But until then, I'm really excited that I could go experience what it's like in VR. Being in space, learning about what it would be like to travel through time, we could recreate that experience and you could see it and you could feel like you were really there. That would be really cool. I love building motorcycles. Motorcycles look really cool. Modifying the way that they operate, the way that they look. Not only is it a fun engineering project, then you get to ride it. I still use Lego bricks. In fact, there's a motorcycle set that I just put together.
I actually have this exact motorcycle, and one of the neatest parts is there's a drive shaft, just like on the real bike.
I was lucky growing up that I was encouraged to build things, but I don't think every girl is. They do think it's important when we're thinking about a career to see someone like ourselves. The right way to talk to young girls about engineering, just encouraging them to follow their interests. And if their interest is making things, encouraging them to make things and helping them get those tools. One of the most exciting things for me is that kids that are playing with Lego bricks now and building things now are actually the ones that are going to be building all of these future devices, whether they're going to be artists or hardware engineers like me, or building the worlds digitally. Anyone, whether you're a girl or a boy, you're going to have challenges in getting what you want. You're going to have challenges in getting into a place where you're doing the work that you want. Everybody's going to face those things. That's hard enough without hiding who you are. You know, if you try to hold on to every little thing too tightly, or you're too worried about what school you get into, or too worried about a single grade, you miss the whole point. Stay focused on what you want. So much of my career was about building things myself. And a few years ago, I realized what was just as fun was helping people and helping people become who they wanted to be, or even understand how to become, you know, more empowered. If they're LGBTQ and they're not out at their workplace and they come to our workplace and they feel comfortable being out, there's a whole lot of stress that alleviates. And then they could focus more on what they love to do. And that's something I'm really proud of.